I am at your service, Captain.
We have it. Go ahead.
Curious feeling.
It fits.
That you've seen something that no one else has.
But it's restabilized.
That you know something no one else does.
No, it's the same as before. There's a massive output as the artifact is added. Then it harmonizes. Like it's waiting for the others.
That's speculation, but I think you're right. We need more. Here. You've earned this. Welcome to Constellation. As a full member this time. Honestly, this just makes it more official. Call it right person, right place, right time. But once the artifacts started coming together, you were one of us. Well, if you ever find a relic bottle from Earth, we'll all be happy to share it with you. By the way, how would you like to keep traveling together? I'm not sitting behind my desk for this. These artifacts are a new chapter for Constellation, and I'm going to be out there for it. And I want you out there as well. You got results. I need someone like you watching my back. Oh, we'll be working with everyone here at the Lodge sooner or later. Constellation is all in on this. Sometimes we'll partner up, sometimes we'll go solo. It's not a formal arrangement. We just came back with good news. We've got momentum. Why not keep going? All right. We've got a few more leads we should talk about. First, there's an expedition that Samco has been putting together. It's in Freestar Collective Space, and he knows it inside and out. There's also the Eye, our star station in orbit. About time for you to meet Vladimir. He's been hard at work tracking down more anomalies. And last but not least, Noelle. Have we heard anything from Barrett yet?
A courier from Argos Extractors came by to let us know they're packing up the operation on Vectera. But that's it, no other word.
That's not good. We should get over there and check on Barrett in person. Oh, that's right. He wasn't here when you first showed up. He should be back by now. I'll let him handle the introductions. If I steal his thunder, I'll never hear the end of it. His mind is always somewhere, but there's no arguing his knack for being in the right place at the wrong time. Oh, too bad he couldn't see the artifacts coming together. But knowing him, he'll be so excited when he gets a look, it won't occur to him that he's missed anything. We maintain a star station in orbit above us. It's where we do all our deep space scanning. Vladimir runs the station. Brilliant astronomer. Years of practical experience. You can thank Barrett for that, if he's still around to thank when this is all said and done. Honestly, he took this seriously before any of us. It was at his urging that we started doing deep space scans. I will admit, it was something of a shock to see Barrett taking anything seriously. Talk to you later.
I hope you are satisfied with the quarters available to you. Captain, now that you are a member of Constellation, I am at your service. No additional protocols necessary. Also, given the likelihood that you will be out in unsettled space, it might be beneficial to go over exploration outpost development. In case you ever need to build a base for field research. The exploration of an unknown planet can be a major undertaking. By building an outpost, you will be able to construct scanning equipment, resource extractors, and defenses. It is even possible to set up multiple outposts capable of manufacturing, allowing you to build advanced equipment. The blueprints you need to construct an outpost should already be on your watch. It will automatically connect to any available materials for construction in your ship's cargo.
Thank you.
I'm listening.
I'd be happy to carry a few things for you.
Bye-bye. Doesn't look like much, but we should certainly take a look around.
It appears things have gone downhill since the last time you were here.
Well,
Argos has clearly washed its hands of this operation.
Don't you lean me. I thought things had already gone sideways, but no, that was just the beginning. More pirates showed up when you were gone. We weren't as lucky this time. Calvert, Troy, some of the new Dusties. They didn't make it. Well, how could you have? You weren't here. Anyway, I was pinned down behind some crates with Barrett. Bullets and laser fire everywhere. No smile on that damn carefree face of his. Like he knew this was it. I started steeling myself to go out fighting. Then that idiot puts his hand on my shoulder and says, "Stay here, Lynn. I got you."
Not quite. Barrett is more dangerous than you might think.
Next thing I know, two of the pirates are dead, and he's got the third one in a headlock. Drags him out into the open at gunpoint and demands to talk, or else I'm going to demonstrate Newton's third law on this guy's temporal lobe. And that's when they brought out Hela. I didn't overhear everything, but after the 10 longest seconds of my life, Barrett put his hands up, and both of them ended up getting taken aboard the pirate ship. And that's the last I saw of either of them. They could have grav-jumped anywhere. I tried pinging a transmission to the ship in the comms building before they left, but the pirates must have fried it. You want to try it? Go ahead. But the odds of them being alive, even if you could find them... I've lost a lot of people on this run, Dusty. I just want to pack up.
Thank you.
you learned it. You know what, on second thought, I don't want to know.
Before we're out of range.
Out of range of what?
Out of range of the sensor array on Vectera.
Would you keep up?
Once we're outside the star system, the bandwidth goes from instant speed to effectively never.
What good is sending a transmission down there? You gonna tell Lynn how royally screwed we both are? She doesn't even have a ship.
You underestimate how many of my admirers there are in the galaxy, Heller. One of them is bound to show up, looking to reunite with this handsome face.
We're doomed. Capital D, doomed.
Got it, okay. Whoever finds this, I'm attaching the interstellar coordinates to the metadata on the transmission. Rescue us. Repeat, rescue us.
Actually get that computer working again? What? Let me see that. Funny. Even knowing he's alive, I still never want to see him again. Heller, on the other hand... Okay. Let me send you the location data embedded in the transmission. Find them, okay? Be a while before Argos comes to pick me up. I'll be here if you need me. And hey, if you ever need a little extra help, I've been thinking about a career change lately. Maybe it's time to put Argos behind me.
Glad to be a part of the team.
Yeah? If you have any gear you want me to haul, I'm happy to help. Maybe another time.
Research outpost U309 to any and all Freestar Collective craft. We are under heavy fire. Hostile spacers are overrunning our position on Altair 2. I'm not sure how much longer our outpost can hold on. We don't have much time. Private Mahoney, out.
Watch your flaring.
Some pirate coming back to kill me. Lucky me, right? Nah. I'll be alright. Just, you know, wasn't trying to move around too much with all the painkillers and nausea meds running through me.
You should let us help you. There's no reason for you to have to suffer needlessly.
Man, I was so terrified when I got pulled on board that pirate ship. There it was all. Sorry, brother. I'll get us out of this. Trust me. I'm getting to that. He tells me we need to start pretending to fight each other. Trick the pirates into thinking they need to come in before one of us gets killed. I just remember him shouting, "This kid is a killer. How am I supposed to defend myself against these pearly whites? He's gonna bite my face off." I mean, I didn't think it would work, but they came in. All of a sudden, we were wrestling with two of them. Barrett reached for one of their guns. What? Did you say something? Bingo. Blasted the pilot right in the back. Through to the flight console. And dropped orbit like a rock off a high rise. I blacked out. And when I came to, there he was, smiling like it was just another day on the job. You miss the fun part, Heller. I mean, I go through all the trouble of saving your butt, and you weren't even awake to notice. Then he did the little finger gun thing. Oh, yeah. Probably should have talked about that first. Did I mention I'm on a lot of painkillers? So, I was real excited when a ship showed up. Then, less excited when I realized it was a Crimson Fleet ship. And then, really, really less excited when Barrett said, "It's okay. I got this." He mumbled something to him, and then they were all gone. I was drifting in and out, but yeah, I think so. Got a signal from the ship before they grav jumped. Guessing it was Barrett. Haven't really been in a good space to have a listen. Here you go. Hey, I should come with you, right? I don't think anyone else is coming. Don't ask me to operate any heavy machinery for a while. Give me a minute. I think the worst of it is... Yeah, I'll be all right. I'll be all right. Ready to wisecrack with the best of them. Let me know when you want to head out.
We should have a talk. When you have the time, of course. Thanks for taking the time to talk. I wanted to ask you about the artifact you found on Bektera. When you pulled it from the rock, held it in your hands for the first time, how did you feel? Maybe, but I'd appreciate it if you'd hear me out. No, I don't think you understand. I know about the visions, the light, and the music. How did you feel inside? What were your thoughts? That's That's an interesting reaction. But I suppose it shouldn't surprise me. When dealing with the artifacts, common sense tends to go right out the window. If there is, the artifacts are doing a heck of a job hiding it. The artifacts are so different, so alien. And I'm certain one of them reached out and spoke to you. Quite the mystery. That's an excellent question. You'd think after years of gathering data about the artifacts, I'd have the perfect answer to that. But I haven't the faintest idea. Not much, I'm afraid. All I have to show for my efforts are eyewitness accounts, scores of inconclusive metallurgical test results, and wild theories. Oh, no, not at all. There's so much going on there, I can't afford to divert all of our resources, but I have classified the artifacts as a priority project. Frustrating? No. Bewildering? Yes. It would be, oh, well, an explorer's dream to solve a mystery like this. I picked the right person for the job. Look, I wanted to thank you for taking the time to talk, and for keeping an open mind. And I also wanted to say, well, I'm pleased we're on this journey together. It's the best decision I've made in quite a long time.
Still think there might be a spot for me on your ship? I gotta get off this rock. Phew, I'm glad to hear you say that. For a second there, I thought you were gonna leave me behind. What's on the agenda today? You got it. Catch you on the flip side, boss. Thanks for letting me tag along.
Something you need? I'll only carry the good stuff. Just kidding. Time to go?
Don't leave any of that behind.
I got them!
Thank you. Thank you.
bring me anything useful? Bye for now.
Thank you.
I'm betting there's something cheaper you could drop instead.
Their owners for decorating their ships with heat leech nests would be a nice touch.
Yes? Want to see what I'm carrying? Bye. Can I help? Feel free to drop some stuff into my bag. So long.
Thank you.
contrary to what you might have heard, UC security personnel are good people. And Sergeant Yumi just happens to be an old friend.
This really isn't a good place for civilians to be hanging around. There's something I can help you with? Yeah, I can't really just let you in there. You're not getting through. I'm glad you understand the position I'm in here. You know what? I may be starting to like you. This isn't getting us anywhere. I'm gonna need you to clear out of here, or else I'll have to call security.
I wish there were more good people like you out there. Looks like you've got some fines to clear up. I've got special orders. You're coming with me. Prepare for immediate transport to our vessel. I've been authorized to inform you that you're being transferred to the UC Vigilance. You'll find out more when you get there. Other than that, I'm not at liberty to divulge any additional information. We have orders to transport you and your vessel to your final destination, the UC Vigilance. Any deviation from those orders on your part will be considered an act of hostility and will be met with aggressive force. Smart decision. Stand by to be transferred.
Are you lifting off right away, or do you need a little bit of time?
I'm telling you, the commander's got plans for this loser. Why else would he be going through all this trouble?
I still don't understand why he trusts a criminal. Seems like too much of a risk.
Stop worrying and keep an eye on our guest. I'll be right back.
You just sit tight. The commander wants to have a little chat.
The prisoner's ready, sir.
I hope you're comfortable. We have a lot to discuss. Highly perceptive. Let me add that to your list of skills. Speaking of which, let's see what we're working with here. Looks like you spent some time as a professor. Having that sort of educational aptitude makes you an ideal candidate for our operation. I also see that you've mined on Vectera, and now you're with Constellation. You've certainly been quite busy. Oh, and look at that. Right at the bottom of this list is the criminal incident that landed you in my crosshairs. Good. You'll find that I'm a stickler for details, and I'd hate to discover that your file is incomplete. Now that we have that out of the way, let me introduce myself. My name is Commander Kibwe Ikande, and I'm in charge of this operation for UC SysDev. Are you familiar with what we do? Actually, that's something new we're trying. I figured we needed to branch out a bit, broaden our horizons. UC SysDev is a division of the UC Navy. Well, they handle the big picture stuff. We deal with a very particular problem. The Crimson Fleet. That convict is where you enter the picture. No, you don't. Not yet, anyway. We've been prodding at the Crimson Fleet for years, trying to take them down one ship at a time. But we barely scratched the surface. If we can get someone on the inside, we'd have a shot at finding a loose thread we can pull to bring it all down. Not for me. For yourself. Look, I'm going to make this simple. Agree to work for UC SysDev, and together, we take down the Crimson Fleet. Refuse, and I tell these guys to throw you into the nearest lockup. Might even tack on an extra few hundred credits to your fine. Well, first of all, we'll forget about the infraction that landed you on the Vigilance. Wipe the slate clean. Better still, depending on how well you do your job, we'll even kick in a few extra credits to offset any cost that the operation will incur. Or, you can throw all that away and end up back in jail with a hefty fine attached. Oh. Of course you have a choice. It's just stacked in my favor. So, what do you say? You going to work with me, or should I find someone else? Suit yourself. You know, I have to admit, I'm a bit surprised. My instincts told me you were the right person, but I suppose I was wrong. All right, send this one to the lockup on Cydonia. Let them deal with the problem.
Arrested, searched, and thrown in a cell. Not my idea of a good time.
Hello? Those tend to stay out of trouble. Visitors? That's a nice thing.
Found a clutch of heat leeches.
Thank you.
Dennis.
Another point for our side. They've got any weapons or ammo.
Thank you.
Set aside anything useful and just leave the rest.
another one!
You think he's a spacer? He's the one that cleared him out. Corporal Izama, UC Marines, medic. We thought we were done for.
I'm...
And meet the esteemed doctor. Musa, right? It's his party we're crashing. I'm a battlefield medic, so this, outpost? Well, it's luxury accommodations. What the heck are you guys doing here anyway? Doctor. Doctor!
Yes. I mean, yes. Astrobiology. We study non-Terran life forms in the settled systems. We, seek to understand the various flora and fauna and search for practical uses. No. They've been trying to take over the whole system. For months.
Listen, we can't waste time. The Freestar CO, Lieutenant Torres, he locked down the complex. I'm not sure how long he can keep his troops safe.
Last I saw Torres was on the third floor, near my office.
Take this key and get to Torres. It should open everything except the security doors. Get to Torres before his men are wiped out. Good luck.
violence. It's so senseless. Don't the spaces realize we're trying to help them? Help everyone.
When you have a few moments, there's something I'd like to discuss. What can I help you with? Remember our last conversation when you told me the artifacts made your mind and body feel out of sync? Well, it got me thinking. So I dove into our archives and started looking through Constellation's older journal entries. Just because I wasn't familiar with the experience you described doesn't mean the same might have been true for my predecessor. Really? I'm surprised that I haven't. After reading those journals, all of the pleasant memories of my time spent with Aja just started flooding back. Aja Mamasa. She was the youngest member of Constellation when it was founded. Only took her 15 years to reach chair. Sorry, I sometimes get so caught up in my own bubble, I forget that I wasn't the first. Ah, she absolutely was. Aja was the one that taught me the ropes at Constellation and took me under her wing as her protege.
Now that you mention it, you're probably right. Either way, we logged quite a few interesting discoveries together. Honestly, it wasn't so much what Aja and I discovered in our travels. It was the journey that was memorable. Exactly. For me, it was all about the quieter moments. There was nothing quite like sitting back and watching space bend while listening to Aja spin vivid stories to fill the time. Oh, I find that sort of cozy isolation the best way to really get to know someone. Yeah, you know, being alone in interstellar space, nothing but light years of black around you. Some people find that terrifying. I find it comfortable. It helps me bond with my shipmates. I'll take that as a compliment. Thank you. You know, all this talk about Aja reminds me that my time with her was a gift. I miss her dearly. No, she retired. Living on Porima 2 now, I think. Come to think of it, if we're ever out that far, perhaps we could pay her a visit, and I could make proper introductions. I don't expect you to be a carbon copy of Aja. Just be yourself. You see, it's clear that we share the same hunger to discover what's out there. And that, well, that's what intrigues me about you. I don't know if I deserve to be that close to anyone right now. If you knew about the things that I've done, the way my life's unfolded, I think your opinion of me might change. Please give me some time. I have to go. You've got something for me? Have something for me? Until later. I'm sure they had something we can use.